5 minutes, the attacking section had lost all sense of urgency. because after all, you are a symptom of nature. You, as a human being, you grow out of this physical universe in just exactly the same way that an apple grows off an apple tree. So let's say the center of consciousness.
Yeah. evolutionary state. is the longest, and it's the best. During that stage, the dream is beautiful. The second stage is not quite so long, and it's a little unsettling. There's an element of instability in it, a certain touch of insecurity. In the third stage, which is not, again, so long, the forces of light and the forces of darkness, of good and of evil, are equally balanced, and things are beginning to look rather dangerous. And in the fourth stage, which is the shortest of them all, the negative, dark, or evil side triumphs, and the whole thing blows up. And so then there's a waking period before the whole thing starts again. We are seeing here the fundamental principles of drama. Two-thirds of the time. And this is a very ingenious arrangement, because we are seeing here the fundamental principles of drama.
We'll be right back. And this is the era of exploration.
Everything is about to get very complicated. We are all going to become the masters of the narrative in which we are embedded. We will each move into a cosmos of our own creation and control.
Thank you.
problem was nobody knew how to get off.
Thank you. this word. You won't find this word in any dictionary.
What they meant was, use your voice to make an object. And as I understood, I felt a bubble kind of grow inside of me. And I watched these little elf tykes jumping in and out of my chest. They like to do that to reassure you. And they said, do it. And I felt language rise up in me that was unhooked from English. And I began to speak like this. Io te che me hua guapsi che pipin ne tof me te gide che pua accent moi fuau guapsi che pipit e de gigi me mua hua begangito i pua fepsi de me gigingi toi ua aganti huia de hinunch ve mua agabete dunci che beha gongte pio oi de dino mi hitti che pito hinen or words to that effect. And I wondered then what it all meant and why it felt so good if it didn't mean anything. And I thought about it a few years, actually. And I decided, you know, that meaning and language are two different things, and that what the alien voice in the psychedelic experience wants to reveal is the syntactical nature of reality, that the real secret of magic is that the world is made of words, and that if you know the words that the world is made of, you can make of it whatever you wish. Yebeko gengi toi yes teach me the hego flekek ze mo ha ga ba hego vi tuch mi ge be higi nun ek hep si ti vo ma wa wa ha ya ba ga hek lo de be gonge puata ze mo ha kuap si ki pipin. And one of the things that I learned about DMT was that if you've ever had it, even just once, then you can have a dream. And in this dream, somebody will pull out a little glass pipe. And then it will happen. It will happen just like the real thing, because there's a button somewhere inside each and every one of us that gives you a look into the other side, and that's the button that resets the compass that tells you where you want to sail. Good luck.